Hi, and welcome to this edition of Ask the Expert. My name is Daniel Pfisterer. I'm a Punch application engineer here at Trump's Customer and Technology Center in Farmington. Today, we're going to cover tapping, how to set up your tools, and how to program for them.
So on Trump machines, there are a couple different ways that we can form threads. We can form threads with an extrusion, which is ideal for thinner sheets, and we can form threads without an extrusion, which is best for thicker materials. For thread forming with an extrusion, we first need to pre-punch the material, and then we extrude the material. The video shows in upform that we can also downform extrusions. After we have our extrusion, we can come in with the tap itself. The extrusion gains us holding power in thin sheets, so this process can replace things like PEM inserts and weld nuts. Here we see the tapping process without an extrusion, so there's the pre-punch, and then the tapping. Form threads are going to be stronger than cut threads and are formed in a chip-free process, so we don't have to worry about chips or shavings scratching the sheet or gumming things up. Now we'll take a look at the two types of tapping tools. There's a type 1 tool and a type 2 tool. You'll feel the tool settle into place when it's aligned, and we want to keep it aligned for assembly. The difference between the type 1 and type 2 tool is the internal gear ratio. The type 1 tool will spin the tap 11 times per tool rotation, while the type 2 tool spins the tap 3 times per tool rotation. And each tap is tool specific, so make sure you're using the proper forming head for each tap. So to assemble a tapping tool, we need our tap, lead screw, spindle nut, forming head, die shoe, and a cartridge. First, we insert the forming tap into the lead screw. It'll click into place when it's properly aligned, and each tap has a lead screw that's specific to it. We then thread the spindle nut onto the lead screw, and the point of the tap should be flush with the spindle nut. So a good way to align the two is to place the spindle nut on a flat surface and then thread the lead screw into it while gripping lightly. The tap assembly can then be inserted into the forming head. The spindle nut has a notch that aligns with the screw to hold it in place. And the gears won't always line up perfectly, so you can rotate a little bit until the tap assembly slides into place and then tighten the securing screw. The die and die shoe can then be clicked into the cartridge, and we want to make sure you're using the proper die for your tap size. Then the tap forming head can be clicked into the cartridge using the loading aid, and we're good to go. If you're using an extrusion tool, select the proper die, and it goes into the die shoe. Then the extrusion punch with poly stripper can be installed in the cartridge. For programming, we are in boost, and we'll be tapping M4 threads into 120 steel. So select the M4 tap, click on automatic thread creation, and apply the processing to your part. The proper pre-punch size will be generated for your setup plan. Here you can see the pre-punch and then the threading on the outside. In this piece of 080, we're tapping M4 holes with an extrusion. So we select automatic thread creation, then we select thread with extrusion, and we apply the process to the part. As you can see, the appropriate pre-punch, extrusion, and tap have been applied.
Thank you for watching this edition of Ask the Expert. If you have any questions, please reach out to our applications department.